Now we're fully configured, so I can say, I can go up here and click on the start sampling button. So now it's gonna start communicating to the RS5, and what you start off in is preview mode. So you're not yet recording data, but this gives you a chance to make sure, okay, I chose my edge right here. Make sure that you have good cells. You have at least two good cells, and it's consistently. If you get too close to the edge, you might have two cells, zero cells, two cells, zero cells. So you wanna make sure that's not the case. It's better to move out a little farther into the transect and get good velocity data below the RS5 for the full 10 samples in a row than it is to get measure as much as you can right up next to the bank. So I'm looking at this bottom velocity map and cross-sectional profile, and I'm getting good cells. Each of these colored blocks is an individual cell, and the color represents a different speed for each of the cells. So I'm getting good samples. So I'm gonna say start edge. We already configured that we're on the left bank. Our distance is 2.0 meters, but you could enter this, change this at this point. It's a vertical bank, auto edge profiles, and 10 samples. So I'm gonna click okay. It's already collected 10 samples, so it's gonna jump into the transect. So I can say, okay, Brittany, start moving. Now she's gonna very smoothly and consistently move the boat across the transect. And the idea here is to not make any jerky movements or sudden like direction changes. And what I'm watching is the boat speed to water speed ratio. I'm watching these boat tracks to see how they're doing. And then also I'm watching this left-hand side, there's a QA, QC warning window. So right now I have two warnings. A yellow is a warning, it's not critical, but if the warnings start stacking up, it could pop an error. And those are consider stopping the measurement and changing something about your measurement if you have an error. So we have a few with beam separation. This is not unrealistic for this site. This is a very high flow on the river and pretty turbulent site. Best site along this reach of the river to measure right now, but yeah, as long as you don't have too many beam separations or too many warnings adding up. And for the boat speed to water speed ratio, you want to make sure to keep that, if possible, under one, meaning you're not moving the boat any faster across the channel than the water velocity in the river is moving down the channel. At a site like this and conditions like this, you can move it pretty quickly across and easily stay with the boat speed to water speed ratio under one. If you have very, very slow moving water and it's impossible to keep that boat speed to water speed ratio under one, it would just take all day to make it across the channel. You can also, you can move a little bit faster, but you ultimately want to keep it under two. You never want to be moving faster than two times the water velocity in the channel. Okay, that's end edge. Brittany told me she's at the far edge. So I'm gonna click next, far edge. Distance, we had pre-configured to the 1.94 meters that we measured. It's a sloped bank. And so we click okay. We could change if we needed to. And auto edge is on, so it auto completes because it had already collected 10 samples. So now we're back in preview mode. You can click the tab down here, the tab along the top for the recorded data. And you can take a scan back through your data to make sure that everything looks okay. And we're getting velocities across the whole transect. The boat track looks reasonable. The water velocities, we're getting good water velocity cells all the way across. And we have relatively few warnings and not too many in a row. Go back to the real time tab, and the next option we have is to start the edge. Okay, now we've completed our first transect and we're on the right bank, and so now we're ready to go in and click next, start edge. I'm on the right bank. It has saved our distance that we previously measured and entered, and it's a sloped bank. I click okay. and it automatically switches from edge into transect. So I say, okay, Brittany, start moving. You can see in the sample type, we're in the transect. And now as Brittany comes back across, I'm watching the icons along the top here. I wanna make sure everything's blue. If something goes yellow, that's a warning. And then if it goes red, it means we're not getting one of those things. So BT is for bottom track. The Bluetooth icon is for the communication, the Bluetooth communication. RTK is because we're connected to RTK. That's blue, meaning we have a GPS fixed quality of floor, which is RTK. BTG is also blue. So we're collecting samples. Everything's looking good. I'm watching the QAQC window to see if there's any warnings popping up, and so far so good. I'm watching the top time series plot, which has the boat speed to water speed ratio, which is the green bars. We recommend keeping the boat speed to water speed ratio to 1 or under, and that would be green. So under 1 is green. If you exceed 1, you're gonna get then the orange bars will turn orange. If you exceed 2, it will turn red. So if you see orange, you can tell your boat operator to slow down. And if you see red, you probably need to come back and start a transect over again. Because up to a boat speed to water speed ratio of 2, you're okay. You don't want to be in the 1 to 2 range unless you have to be, but some channels are moving so slow that it's just nearly impossible to have a boat speed to water speed ratio that's under 1. Because again, that's the boat speed is the speed that the boat is moving across the channel versus the water speed is the velocity that the water is moving down the channel. Brittany let me know she's on the left edge. So I set next end edge. It saved our data. It says we're on the left bank. So I'm going to click OK. We see the edge, see that we're getting some good cells. And as soon as we've hit 10 samples on the edge, it's going to automatically end that transect. All right, so now we're back in preview mode. So we can go back and look at our recorded data if we want to, look at the last transect, you can look at the discharge, you can look at the GPS quality, whatever, just make sure again, this is a good chance to do that, make any changes that you need to make. But if you're ready to go, then you can go back, click the real time tab on the top and click next start edge and connect our and start collecting our next edge. So now we're ready for our third transect. So I'm gonna click start edge. We're on our left edge of water. We have our distance saved. So I'm gonna click okay. We're in the edge dialog window. So we can see our velocity. It's collected 10 samples. Auto edge has switched us into the transect. Okay, Brittany, you can start moving. And Brittany's gonna start pulling the boat back across. Okay, so I'm gonna click end edge. It has saved our information for the right bank. We're at the same exact location, so the distance is right. Click okay, and we're seeing a preview for the edge samples. And auto edge has switched us now back into preview mode and ended that transect. So now we are ready to start coming back for another transect. So I can click, I can type F5, or I can click start next edge. And so I click start next edge. It has a right bank, saved our information. I click okay. We're seeing our edge preview. You wanna make sure that you're seeing some velocity cells. Now auto edge has switched it into transect. Okay, start moving, Brittany. And Brittany's gonna bring the boat back. Again, operating the boat as smoothly as she can. There's a elastic harness on the Hydroboard 2 Micro and the Hydroboard 2 full-size board that help to dampen like any jerking, but you wanna try and make sure that you navigate the boat across as smoothly and as consistently as possible. Because we have a bank-operated cableway here, the boat is always facing upstream and we can follow a very repeatable transect back and forth across the channel. It's not 100% necessary, but we have other environmental factors here that are challenging. So because we can set up a bank operated cableway, we have to try and keep the transects as consistent as possible. In reality, in a manned boat, you can go across the channel and you want to operate as smoothly as possible, but you don't have to follow the exact same track there and back. The system will compensate with the GPS and the bottom tracking and internal calculations for boat tracks that are not across the exact same cross section. Ultimately, you want to if you can, but you don't have to. And we like to watch the boat speed to water speed ratio on the top plot. This has defaulted back to bottom track depth and vertical beam depth. So I'm gonna go and say left axis, choosing the summary, and I wanna see the boat speed to water speed there. And okay, Brittany has let me know she's on the edge. I'm gonna say next and edge. Has the left bank, and I'm going to say okay, and we're going to be collecting edge data. Now auto edge has automatically switched us in back into the preview mode, and that completes our fourth transect at this site. We've collected four transects, but our total duration is 9 minutes and 41 seconds, and the USGS SOP, the USGS technical note that describes best operating procedures recommends 720 seconds, which is 12 minutes. So we're gonna take another two transects. So I'm gonna click start edge again. We're on the left bank, it's saved our edge distance. I click okay. And now Brittany is going to start moving as soon as we switch into transect. Go ahead. Okay, so I'm gonna click next and edge. Our edge, it's saved our distance, the method, and it's showing the right bank. Click okay, showing our edge preview, and it's collected 10 samples. So it's transitioning back into the preview mode. And then we'll just click next start edge. It saved our right bank data. I'll click okay. And as soon as we switch from the edge, right edge data screen, that's the easiest way to tell that we're back into the transect. Okay. So now we're there. Okay. Start moving. Okay. So I click next and edge. It saved the left bank data. So I click okay. We're seeing the data being collected for the 10 samples on the end edge. And auto edge has switched us back into preview mode. So we're ready to, so now we've collected six transects with a duration of 13 minutes and 47 seconds, exceeding the 12 minutes recommended for a duration. So we can go ahead and cancel the transect and save and close our measurement.